In this video, I'm going to go over how to calculate percent composition. So here's our formula. We're going to need a few different things. And let's go ahead and do this example. So let's find the percent composition of all elements in H2O. So we can see by looking at the denominator of our formula here that we're going to need the molecular weight. And so that's our first step, is just to find the molecular weight. And so to find the molecular weight, we're going to need the atomic weight and how many of each element we have in that molecule. And so the atomic weight we find off the periodic table. And so here we go, I have the squares from hydrogen and oxygen, and let's go ahead and fill this out. All right, so what I did was I took the atomic weights from both of these periodic table squares, I plugged them in here and here, and then I just followed the subscripts to get how many of each element I had. So for water, I had a subscript of 2 here for H, so I put in 2 right here. And for oxygen, there was no subscript, which means there's an implied 1, so I put a 1 in right here. All right, and so after you add those together, I got a total of 18.015 AMU for my molecular weight. AMU stands for atomic mass unit, but you can also do grams per moles for these. And I just happen to round to 5 sig figs. It depends on what you're doing for your problem to know how many sig figs you want to keep. So now we have the molecular weight, so we can go ahead and plug everything in into our percent composition formula. And so I've outlined it here. This is basically everything we're going to need to plug in. So let's go ahead and just look up at our box up on top. And so first we need the atomic weight of each element. So we can still take that from the periodic table. Then we're going to need how many of each element do we have in the molecule. So this is still back to the subscripts. So for H, we have a subscript of 2. For oxygen, we have no visible subscript. That means we have 1. And now our denominator is the molecular weight that we got over here from step 1. So we can plug that into both. All right, so now we just need to crunch these numbers and go ahead and do the multiplication. And so when we do that for H, we get 11.189%. And when we plug in for oxygen, we get 88.811%. And so just a couple of notes on percent composition here. One good double check for these problems is that you always want to make sure your total adds up to 100%, right? So at the end of the problem, every single element needs to add up to 100% of the total weight. So here we can see that if we added up our two numbers, 11.189 and 88.811, that would give us 100%. So we've done that correctly. And then another thing, we always multiply by 100 in this formula because we are doing a percent. And then I think just something that you want to pick up with on these problems is just to notice the difference between how many of each element you have and what the total mass percent you have is. Because hydrogen, we actually have twice as many as oxygen, right? We have 2 compared to 1. But the total weight is only about 11%, much, much less than just that 1 oxygen. And that's just, of course, because oxygen is a much heavier element than hydrogen. It has a lot more protons and neutrons. It makes it a lot heavier. So just because there are more of a certain element doesn't mean that takes up more of the mass. That's kind of a big lesson from percent composition. All right, I hope this breakdown was useful. Any percent composition of any molecule can be found the same exact way. Just how many elements you have, you just have to make sure you do this little formula for each one, and that's going to give you your percent composition. All right, hope this was helpful, and happy studying. Hey, I hope you liked that video. Please feel free to subscribe, click around, and watch my other tutorials. And as always, happy studying.